You're listening to KFWB News Talk 980. My name is Les Brown, and this is Mamie Brown's baby boy, and we thank you so much for joining us Monday through Friday from 2 o'clock until 4 o'clock. And it's a program that's designed to bring laughter and conversations, and we love to hear stories on a variety of topics that's of interest to you. And we invite you to call us, and we've just been talking to a courageous young lady by the name of Nadine. Nadine was diagnosed 19 years ago with colon cancer, and she had to tell her children. Her son particularly was concerned that she was going to die, and she told her mother. Her mother prayed and said, "I know you're going to be all right." And she told her kids, "I'm going to be just fine. I've got to be here to teach you guys how to cook, and given how hard the struggle is for you to do that, you know I got to be here for a very long time." If you had to identify Nadine, what was it, in addition to the medical treatment, about you that allowed you to still be here 19 years later?
Instead of facing the fear as fear, I shared what positive attitude I had with others.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't allow my children to be afraid.
Yes.
And when I started to feel better, I would go to the chemotherapy clinic and talk with other patients.
Mm.
I would encourage them. I told them all of the things that had brought me to that point.
So while you were going through that experience, you went out and you encouraged other patients as well?
Yes, I did.
And you know, that's a routine that I'm engaging in right now because I'm still involved in a challenge and going through treatment. And so the speech that I give when I go and talk to cancer conquerors that you are more powerful than cancer. And you get some benefit out of that as well.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, because I was more focused on helping others than being afraid that I wouldn't be here.
Yes.
So, and I think that positive outlook, the encouraging of other people allowed me to find my own inner strength.
Mm-hmm.
And so, and that's what sustained me. That's what kept me going.
That's a good idea. You forgot about yourself and you were giving to others. Listen, continue to have that kind of faith, and that a faith-driven life rather than a fear-driven life, living a life of contribution and making a difference in the lives of others, and you will always be blessed.
Thank you.
I appreciate you.
I appreciate you as well. I love the show.
Okay. Thank you so much. The mark of greatness is upon you, Nadine. Lawrence, thank you so much for calling. Lawrence, what is your story? Oh, we lost Lawrence just then. Well, listen, we're winding up. Let me share this with you. One of the things that Nadine said is key. She said she decided while she was suffering from colon cancer, being diagnosed with that 19 years ago, and the prospects did not look good, that she would go out and encourage other cancer patients. I was reading a book called Positivity, and it's evidence-based. When you do good things for other people, when you engage in forgetting about yourself and giving to others, high school principal said, love and happiness are perfumes you can't sprinkle on others without getting a few drops on yourself. That really fortifies your immune system. That begins to create some positive chemicals, healing cells in your body that strengthens you from the inside out. The other thing is, you listen to the story of Sandra. Sandra, who was diagnosed with breast cancer the second time, and the doctors said, oh my goodness, you are pregnant. And the doctor said, you can either have an abortion or you can have radiation and deliver a stillborn. And then she asked, what's my other option? Or you can have chemotherapy. And she went through the chemotherapy, carried the baby for 9 months, not knowing whether or not it was going to be a stillborn, not knowing whether or not the baby was going to be unhealthy. She didn't know any of this, and she kept the faith. And she had to go through chemotherapy, and she said, Les, I ate my vegetables. I was doing all of the alternative healthy things that I can do. See, it's a partnership. Medicine can only do so much. And she said, in my mindset, in my belief, and the baby was healthy, and she's healthy, and she's still here. His name is Salim. Salim means the promise. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you for your calls. Thank you for your contribution. Thank you for your story. The key is, continue to have the faith. 6 weeks ago, my PSA was over 2,000 today. Got the good news. It's down to 271. I've got cancer on the run. I'm going to kick his butt. You better run. You better be scared of me. This has been Mrs. Mamie Brown's Baby Boy. Remember, in order to be successful, you must be willing to do the things today others won't do. In order to have the things tomorrow others won't have. You have something special. You have greatness within you. Always strive to get on top in life, because it's the bottom that's overcrowded. Check you out tomorrow, 2 o'clock. Join us. You've been listening to KFWB News Talk 980.